Hi, I'm Katie and welcome to Be Smart Together. Today, I want to talk about filtering. I am sure you know how to filter data in Excel and Power Query. I want to show you various ways to filter data in Power Query. Before we begin, please click subscribe and turn on the notification to avoid missing valuable videos. Also, feel free to drop a comment or throw me any Excel challenges, and I will show you the best way to deal with them in future videos. The first one is filtering with a parameter. Let's double-click to edit the sales data query. We have already had a filtered step, and we want to edit the step. Double-click on the filtered row step. Click here and select new parameter from the drop-down list. Name the new parameter to selection. Enter Armadale for the current value, then click OK. The filter criteria are now based on the selection parameter. Click OK to continue. Then, click Close and Load. Double-click on the parameter to edit. Change the current value to Adelaide. Then, click Close and Load to continue. Right-click anywhere within the table and select Refresh. Tada, now you only get the Adelaide dataset. This method is easy to learn and use, however, it is more for Power BI than Excel. It is limited to a single value as a criteria input. Personally, I don't use this method in Excel's Power Query. The next one is filtering with the merge method. Let's click here. We want to add a selection table. Then, import it into Power Query. Expand the Queries pane. Go to the Sales Data Query. We want to merge the imported selection table into this query. Choose Selection Input from the drop-down list. Select the key identifiers to merge the two tables. Click OK to continue. Click here to expand and then click OK to get the columns from the selection input table. Click here, select filter, and is not equal. We want to filter out null, so enter null into the value field and click OK. Let's delete the expanded column, then click close and load. Let's change to another suburb from the drop-down list. Let's refresh the table. You will only get the Port Ferry dataset as per the selection. Let's add another suburb to the selection list. Then, refresh the table. The data is returned as per selection. This method is easy to learn, easy to use and a great method for beginners. It allows multiple criteria, and the only downside is more steps. I often use this method for building reports or modeling. The last one is filtering with the M code. Let's duplicate the selection input query. Go to the Transform tab, and click on Convert to List. It converts the selected column to a list. Expand the Queries pane. Go to the Sales Data Query. Click here to add a custom step. We need to overwrite the formula. We need to use Table.SelectRows, List.Contains and List.Buffer formulas. Click Close and Load. Let's add another suburb to the selection list. Then, refresh the table. The data is returned as per selection. The benefit of this method is fewer steps, allows multiple criteria and is customizable. However, it requires users to put effort to learn the M code. It is an essential skill to build advanced and dynamic models. Thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video helpful. Please don't forget to click like if you like the video.